Hello and welcome to the new series of the videos. It's about site and landscape. So we're going to talk about importing the topography file from AutoCAD to Revit. Then we're going to try two different methods to create topo surfaces. We're going to split the surface to simulate the streets. We're going to work with material and finish. We're going to work with graded region to create a topography schedule and to see how we can minimize the excavation. And then we're going to talk about how to create a tunnel and how to take care of the landscape design. So this is the topography that we have. It's already created in AutoCAD in 3D. You can use the same file that you use for project part 1 and part 2. I'm going to go ahead and import the topography here. Import CAD. You can select the DWG file. And I want to invert the colors because usually the AutoCAD file is black, has a background of black color. So if you invert it, the colors are going to show better. I want to change the units to meters, and I know that the Revit is also set to meters, so it's going to work well. Make sure if you want to create topography based on the lines that you get from AutoCAD, current view only should not be checked, right? Because we want the topography to be in all views, to be in 3D, and that's good. You can go ahead and select that, hit open. Very good. Now let's go to the site view, see what's going on. As you see, the building is over there. This is a very big AutoCAD file, but that's okay. We're going to place the building somewhere over there. Okay, we can always fix that later, but I'm going to go ahead and move the AutoCAD file from here to there. Okay. So you can select the landscape file. You need to unpin the CAD file to be able to move it. And I'm going to move it from somewhere around here to somewhere around here. You can always work with this later. So that's not a problem. Okay, there we go. So this is in 3D. You can see that the building is way below the topography, but that's okay. We'll take care of it later. We can create the topography first, and we can take care of the levels next. Okay, so let's go to massing and site and topo surface, and we can go with the hard method or the easy one. The hard way to do it is to place points. The easy one is to create from import. I want to show you the hard way first and the more efficient way second. So let's go to the site. Let's start with place points. If you zoom in, you're going to see that the heights are mentioned here. For instance, any point on this curve has a height of 110, right? And it should be in meters, but we can double check. So before putting any points, first I want to change this to find. I want to put this on wireframe. When it's on place point, I want to assign elevation first and then click. So that's the trick. Elevation first, click second. I want to put 110. And you can add points here, here, all over that curved surface. The higher the number of points, the more precise it's going to be, and you do not need to close or anything. You can just change the number here to 105 and click on the 105 meters curve. Okay, let's assume we do it for all the curves. You can check the box. We can see how it looks like. It's something like that over there. You see it. Right, so the elevations are in meters. They match with what we have here with the 3D model, but this is not the most efficient way to do that. So I'm gonna delete that topography. And in the next week video, we're gonna use a better way to create topography from AutoCAD file.